So we have had some animals that have been eating, getting into the coop area at night and eating our food. So, I've been giving the chickens kind of like a day's worth of food every day with a scoop of oyster shells. Just so that if an animal gets in there, even though we have an electric fence, that we don't lose so much food. All right, here they are. All the chickens. Here we have a bunch of chicks that we just got to replace the first ones. We have solar here for our electric fence. We have this incredible fence. We do move our chickens often, which is why we have them in this movable fence, so that they always are getting fresh grass. So actually today, I think I'm gonna let the girls free range. So often I will just open up the chicken coop. This is our chicken coop my husband built. We got one laying in there already. Here we fill their food. And sure enough, their food is empty. Okay, so we used to use fancy chicken waterers, and I quit doing that because it was too much work. Now we're using these bowls that we have for our pigs, and it's much easier to refill the water and keep it fresh. So I'm gonna go over here. We actually have two of these fences that connect, and I'm gonna disconnect. I'm gonna let them out today, that they can free range, eat all the chiggers, which I have chiggers on my ankles. They bit me everywhere. And fuck. Let's see if I can get this up. There we go. We'll just let them out. Here we go, girls. We do not have any roosters. That's the girls. Just the girls. So I love this fence because it's super easy. It just stakes right in. And you can move it. And it's really easy to use. Set it like that for today. Let them run around. Hopefully they don't get in the road. But if they do, alright, now that the chickens are all taken care of, they have food and water. I have a busy day, so we're going to have more left in the house. Bed. I'm going to take you guys to the greenhouse. And here's a quick update is that we have lived in D.C. for 2 years now. And I absolutely love it. My favorite part of living in Tennessee is the weather, in all honesty. We'll have a 60, 70 degree day in December, and then we'll have a 20 degree day. And where we moved from in Cleveland, Washington, we had winter snow on the ground for months. And so I just really like the ebb and flow of